Hey, Ron here from Military Images Magazine with a new episode of Life on the Civil War Research Trail. Today we're talking about this officer here, Robert Anderson, Major Robert Anderson. I have a little bit of a soft spot for Anderson and other senior officers who were present during the Civil War at key moments, but didn't live that long after the war. And as a result, they missed an opportunity to talk about their service and their Civil War experience. And we Americans, those of us who inherited the history of the country and continue to talk about the history, we lost an opportunity to hear from them in their own words about what it felt like to be at a certain place at a certain time at a critical moment in the history of the country. And so Robert Anderson needs no introduction. Born in Kentucky, Union loyal, service for a few decades before the war, wounded in the war with Mexico in the 1840s. In the Civil War, of course, he's in charge of the garrison at Fort Sumter, surrenders the garrison after a bombardment April 12th, April 13th, leaves the fort after, at the end of the war's end, 1865, comes back ceremonially, returns with the Stars and Stripes, puts it back on the flagpole. And there are interviews with him. You can find them in a few places, but we don't have that perspective of a longer afterlife. He dies in 1871. And so we don't get to see that Robert Anderson, maybe how would he have described the war in later in the 1870s or in the 1880s? Of course, he was not a young man when he passed. He was in his mid 60s. So he was already getting up there, at least by 19th century standards. All that was in my head this morning when I was reading about a photographer who photographed Robert Anderson. The photographer is George Gardner Rockwood, and he was a pioneer photographer during the daguerreotype era. And when the war begins, he continues to adapt photography as the technology is changing. He makes the change from the daguerreotype world to cartes de visite and paper photographs. And so Rockwood stays in the business for a long time, up until his death in 1911. So we're 50 years after the war. During those later years, photographer George Gardner Rockwood liked to tell stories about some of the famous folks that he talked to, the famous folks that posed for photographs in his New York City studio. And one of those folks happens to be Major Robert Anderson. This is a brief anecdote, but I think it's telling, and it's not an anecdote that I've seen anywhere else. This comes out of a New York City newspaper that is basically Rockwood's obituary. And I want to read you this brief note here. And just to set it up, we're probably sometime in the 1860s. When Anderson is in New York City and goes into Rockwood's studio. And so they have a little conversation, right? The photographer wants to get to know a little bit more about his subject, get him comfortable before they pose for the image. And so there's going to be a little chit chat. And depending upon the nature of the relationship, it can be chatty or not chatty. In this case, we have a little bit of a detail, a little bit of a little passage from the conversation with Major Anderson. So here we go. Quote, Major Anderson became one of Mr. Rockwood's friends. And once, when the major was posing for a picture, Mr. Rockwood asked him if it were true that he had been on the point of surrendering Fort Sumter. In telling the story, Mr. Rockwood used to say that the major replied with great earnestness. Now, here's the quote from Major Anderson talking to photographer Rockwood. Quote, "No, Mr. Rockwood, when I raise that flag on high with a prayer to Almighty God for its protection, I knew that it would never come down in disgrace." Great quote from Robert Anderson. And when you take that quote about knowing that the Stars and Stripes would never fall in disgrace, and you think about his heroism in those early days in April 1861, when his garrison was being bombarded, and he stayed true to the very end until he was forced to surrender, leaving with the flag after it was taken down. And then in 1865, when he returns to Fort Sumter after the United States forces recapture the fort and puts the flag back up, this quote has even more meaning, I think. So I just want to share that with you. And we'll have a new episode with another quote or another passage or another interesting story from the 19th century and the Civil War. Until then, take care.